All right. Hey everybody, welcome back to another...
Oh. You stop that.
Okay.
This is my channel, sir. But we are here at the Gamers Nexus office, and we are continuing to work on stuff that I have never done before. I've done some extreme overclocking stuff on my channel, but I was working with a much simpler setup. You know, I used some chilled water, and we did as well as we could with that setup, but we're going to go a little bit lower than that today.
Yes. Probably about minus 160 degrees lower than you were.
Well, that seems like it should be pretty good to cool this 3950X down to like one minus 140 or something
like
that.
Yeah, then hopefully we'll hit maybe 5-point-something gigahertz. I don't know.
All right, let's go for it. So this setup is obviously a little more complicated, and we're gonna have to worry about messing with some settings in BIOS that I'm not normally changing when I'm doing even chilled water overclocking. So talk to me a little bit about this setup, what we have to be concerned about here, and also what settings in BIOS we might be looking at that we wouldn't otherwise.
So I think on the setup side, I think it's actually a lot easier than chilled water, just because with chilled water, you have to do a lot more of insulation work and worrying more about just water condensation and like running down tubes and stuff like
constantly
that.
Constantly like wiping stuff off.
On fittings, and, like, you were saying, right?
It was condensating on the fittings. Yeah. And like I had my tubes wrapped in paper towels.
Yeah, so this to me is a lot easier these days. But the settings in BIOS are definitely more complicated.
Yeah, like what settings are especially important for this kind of stuff?
So we can go through some of that in BIOS. And the main ones are going to be Infinity Fabric has to be brought down, which is counterintuitive, but I'll explain that a bit later. And then there's a whole bunch of LN2 settings that allow for cold boots specifically. So if you bring this specific setup down below minus 90, it will stop turning on, period. And to get it lower, you have to turn on a whole bunch of settings in BIOS. And then also there's things like VDDG is a voltage we'll have to increase. With a lot of LN2 settings, and you'll find this with some of the XOC guys who actually do this properly too, with a lot of the LN2 settings, it's one of those things where I know what numbers it needs to be. I don't necessarily know what it does.
Okay.
So.
All right, hey, as long as we get there. I don't really care how.
You just change stuff until it works.
Yeah, I'm going to go to sleep in the car. You wake me up when we arrive.
Yeah, okay. Basically. So setup is easy. I do Vaseline on the board, and there's some over here, but I put it everywhere just in case we're going to do GPU, which we're not today, but... Vaseline on the board, there's an LN2 pot, so these liquid nitrogen pots are really dense copper. You picked it up earlier.
Yeah, it was like 15, 20 pounds.
Yeah,
it's mounted here without any kind of retention. It's just the weight
of it
is actually enough pressure so that it's properly mounted.
And then we run a thermocouple to the LN2 pot. That goes to a thermocouple reader, and that allows us to see the temperature of the LN2 pot because the CPU die will stop reporting temperature below 1 or so. And I packed in some paper towels around this because we're going to get some LN2 vapor as we pour, especially because you're going to be doing a lot of the pouring. So I'm expecting it will go everywhere except for the LN2 pot.
I'm aiming just in this vicinity.
Okay, great.
And I don't really know what's going to happen.
Perfect. Just generally at the motherboard. And ideally, I should have flipped this power supply if we were doing a long LN2 session, but it's fine. Just because the power supply fan will pull in the LN2 vapor.
Right.
But because we're only going to do this for a little bit, it's okay. And I think that covers the base setup about as efficiently as I possibly can.
Yeah, you did a good job. So before we even started this, we were over at the big nitrogen tank, and you filled up this Dewar.
Yes.
It's just a little bit easier to work with than worrying about.
Way easier. I've poured LN2 from the tanks straight into thermoses before, and it just kind of sucks. You get it all over the place. But that's pretty much it for this process.
So we're in BIOS here, and what are the first things we're going to take a look at, and then before our first boot, and before we start playing with
things? Right now we're at 22 degrees Celsius, which is completely fine. This will stay cold for a while. We're using a Der Bauer Beast pot, LN2 pot on this, and those will, it's got so much copper that it'll be fine. So we want, I don't know if I just typed that, I think, auto. So the main settings we're going to change, core ratio, obviously, you know that one. And we've got core voltage, V-core. We're also going to be changing all of the power settings, so like load line calibration, LLC it's known as. We'll change the protections for overcurrent, overvoltage. I don't know, do you normally change those for your ICE stuff?
I don't know, I don't.
That'd probably give you some more headroom too.
Think so?
Yeah, well, it depends on the motherboard. Yeah. So some boards will ignore these limits, but some don't, and you can be current limited. And then we have SoC voltage will help with stability, mostly with memory. With AMD, you have to be careful of SoC voltage because even on air, on non-LN2, if it's too high, you are at risk of degrading the IMC. Mm. But if we're under LN2, then we're kind of already assuming that there's going to be some degradation over time if we do this a lot. These just help with booting and mostly with extreme cold. Where's the AMD settings? AMD's got their own overclocking.
Yeah, AMD overclocking stuff.
Yep, and this is provided
by... This is new for this generation.
That's right. They provide this to the vendors, so this is all done by AMD. The main one we change in here is going to be Infinity Fabric. We're going to have to drop down. So the problem is Infinity Fabric, the CPU does not like booting... It does not like clocking high, I should say, like over 5 gigahertz, from what I found, from what Joe was talking about too, with Ryzen 3000. It just won't boot above 5 with Infinity Fabric at like 1800, 1900.
Yeah.
So it hates cold. For whatever reason, IF really hates cold, so we drop it down to 1467.
And you said also, like, even when I'm doing chilled water, that might actually help me.
It could help.
Clock like a little bit higher.
Yeah, it could definitely help.
Yeah.
And then also booting with a lower voltage and frequency, and then changing the rest in the OS can help too.
Right.
Booting at a higher voltage will sometimes be unstable.
I mean, honestly, that's pretty interesting because a lot of those settings are not something that even people who are doing significant overclocks on air, water, you know, and AIO are not even going to worry about.
Yeah.
But why don't we lay down a baseline and then we'll jump back in here and we'll make some changes and we'll see how high we can get.
Yeah, sounds good. Kay.
Yeah, so we booted into Windows, and we're just going to do a quick Cinebench R15 run. There's no LN2 in the pot right now.
Right. And it might get hot, but we'll find out.
It's yeah, well, I guess we'll find out.
That's not bad. So it's in the mid-60s degrees Celsius with no LN2 in there. And we are also no settings except XMP and 3200 megahertz.
So 4044. How does that compare to where you ended up?
So I ended up at about 5246 at 5.2 gigahertz.
Yeah.
And I think AMD at their original event with this CPU got actually a score a little higher than that. So that their score was more efficient than mine, which means there's probably some more tuning I could do for my settings.
Right.
Because, I mean, AMD employees doing AMD overclocking,
yeah,
they know better than I do. But, yeah, that's so we've got a long way to go.
I think so.
We have about 1,000 points to climb.
I think we could do it.
I hope so.
All right.
See.
Let's get to work.
So let's just get booted at 4.6. So do 46 for the ratio. And the fact that it makes it red kind of weirds me out.
But, yeah.
It's 46, and then let's go down to voltage. And we're just going to set a kind of high voltage just to get it working for time's sake.
Yeah.
So auto, we change that to 1.42. That's going to be a little on the high side. But
you said 4.2?
Yeah. This CPU is really good, so I think that'll work.
Okay. You going to change the SoC at all?
SoC we can leave alone for now.
Okay.
So let's do 1.35 for that. And LN2 mode we're going to want on, so we can... Okay, and then, yeah, LN2 mode. So enable that. And it's back out. And go up to Infinity Fabric. 1467. And if anyone is like, how do you know all these numbers? The answer is trial and error.
Yeah, you've done some significant testing with this chip already.
Yeah.
You did a whole cold scaling video.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm sure that helped helped inform your knowledge about all these settings.
Yeah, and it does.
It's good for something like this where we're trying to learn the basics and I don't want a trial and error.
Yeah, no, that's not the fun part for learning. And also, it's just, if anyone's like, is it just math? Like, can you just do math to figure these out or is it... anything special, try it until it doesn't work and then go back.
Sure.
So you don't need to fill it up.
Yeah.
Just splash it like, you can do more than that. And let's keep an eye on the top number on that thermocouple reader. You want that to come down to, we'll probably just bring it down to like minus 40 or so to start with.
So keep splashing it.
Yeah,
until
you've
we
got
hit
a
that.
Ways to go.
Okay.
I'd fill it up maybe halfway to 3/4 the way. And let it bubble down.
What have you found to be stable without LN2 with this chip?
This one's really good. I think this one was almost 4 or 5 on a 280 millimeter liquid cooler.
Oh, that is really good.
Yeah, the voltages it can do are low. I want to say, it's all in our reviews. I might be misremembering. I think it was 1.2 3.2, 3 volts at 4.4 gigahertz all core.
Yeah.
Which is like crazy compared to Ryzen 2.
Yeah.
Per second. Yeah.
I think this poor should get us to minus 40.
I think so. Yeah, so you can hit
How high do you want it? How full should we keep the pot while we're in this stage?
So, for like Time Spy Extreme or something, I'll keep all the pots pretty full until the end of the benchmark, then you stop pouring. Because one thing you don't want is to plunge the temperature at the end of the benchmark when the load goes away.
Okay.
So if you have an active load of a couple hundred watts and suddenly that load goes away, there's nothing to kill the LN2 anymore.
Right.
You can plunge the temperature and then have a cold boot or a cold shutdown. So we should be fine though. So.
Okay. So let's run this.
Yep. And this benchmark is so short that you won't even really need to pour. And then if you ever do longer benchmarks, like, again, Time Spy Extreme, you'll be pretty active on the pouring. Makes it fun.
4663. Yeah.
Just like that.
Yeah.
It's easy.
That's not bad.
So,
I
think we were at 4004 originally, right?
Yeah.
Something like that?
4044.
Okay, yeah. And that was stock.
Right.
So that's a pretty big jump for very little actual effort.
Yeah, this took 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, and that's with all the explanation. Let's bring it up higher so we can reboot. Sometimes I'll use Ryzen Master for this, but it's a little buggy still. And sometimes you'll open Ryzen Master and it'll say, please kindly abort, or please kindly reinstall the program, or anything to say that it's not working.
Yeah.
So I just try not to use it if I can avoid it. So let's go up to, let's try 50. Let's just get you to 50. And then for core voltage, so this is where I've pre-tested this chip. You know, it makes it really easy, but if you're doing this on your own, you basically, what I would do is set a high number like 1.5.
And then work down from there.
And then work down.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just because it saves frustration to start low, start high and come down. So I would say, what did we do, 5? I'd say try 1.43.
Okay, we were just at 1.42, so that's all we need.
I think so.
All right. So we're booted and stable at 4.9. We tried 5. We ran into a few difficulties. Either the mount is maybe off a little bit, or you said maybe there's some condensation down
by
the socket.
I didn't insulate the back as much as I normally do, the socket, so it could be condensation, it could be the mount. The motherboard was saying like VGA error, CPU error.
Yeah, we spent I don't know, how long was that, half hour trying to figure that out, 20 minutes, something
like
that.
Yeah, 15.
But 15 minutes. Whatever it was, so we just backed it off. One click to 4.9, and that's what we're running
it's
now.
It's running. So it's working again. Yeah, 4951 for the score. It's about 1-to-1 with, like, 4.9 gigahertz, we're at 4,900 points.
Yeah.
So, it's looking good, and we're at 1.6 volts.
Yeah.
I decided to just jump it, make it work.
Yeah, just to get it going again. Do you want to try any higher? Or?
Yeah, let's try and get a, well, let's, yeah, let's try and get a 5.0.
A 5.0? Okay, we'll try to keep the same voltage maybe in a 5.0, or you want to step it up 1.65, 625?
We can try and keep it the same.
Try to keep it the same.
Yeah.
All right, let's do that. Let's try it.
It's working so far.
This is better than before.
It's a lot better than before. There you go.
2.9.
So now you've done 5 gigahertz on.
I have hit 5 gigahertz on Ryzen.
Yeah.
Which is something that I had not come close to before.
Yeah, well.
I never did any chilled water overclocking with my 3950. On the cooling setup that I have right now, it's just an air cooler, but it runs all core 4.3. It's running great.
Yeah.
5 gigahertz on these 16 core chips is pretty impressive.
It still tears through. It tears through like Blender too for. It's not practical, but even though you're dropping Infinity Fabric for tile-based renderers like Cinebench and Blender and stuff like that, we were able to get this CPU pretty close to the 2990WX previous 32-core performance, I think. And actually, we're starting to approach the new Threadripper 3 performance with a 5.3 gigahertz overclock.
Yeah, that's as high as you got, was 5.3.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we were close. We got. I guess if we kept working, we can probably get there.
We could definitely get there.
Yeah, but this was a great experience, and I really appreciate you setting this up for me.
Yeah, it's a lot of. I mean, you got the real experience too. Of we only had one hiccup there, and it really wasn't bad in the scope of LN2.
Yeah.
But 20-30 minutes, something. of stuff just not working.
You're trying to figure it out.
It happens all the time with this stuff. And if you're interested in this or even just like the chilled water overclock, which is pretty accessible for people, then I'd say the biggest piece of advice I have is be patient and do it not under a time crunch. We're under a bit of one, but it's fine. Like, I'm kind of a professional, not at this. I'm a professional in other things, so that's good enough. And so as long as you're like patient, then it's pretty fun.
Don't expect immediate results. Like, you're gonna have to trial and error it quite a bit, especially if you're first starting out. Like, I mean, the most that I've done, like I said, is the chilled water stuff, and even that, I'll be working at that all day.
Yeah. You know? Oh yeah.
And it, sometimes it works, and sometimes you just get real frustrated.
But you gotta walk away from it.
Yeah. But this is a lot of fun. If you guys don't know Steve, go check out Gamers Nexus. Subscribe to him on YouTube. Link down below. Thanks again, Steve, for having me down here. This was great, and I really enjoyed my time here.
Yeah, and check out his other videos too.
Yeah, I did the XOC stuff.
You got the vlog coming up that you were doing here.
Yeah, shot a vlog here. Did a
old hardware.
The old hardware video also, and then the videos that we did for you with the water cooled build.
Yeah.
So a lot of stuff that we shot down here. It was a good weekend. So thanks a lot, man.
Yeah.
And get subscribed to the channel if you're not already, and I'll see you next time.
First on these. And it'll get cold really fast and can't hold it for too long. I really opened it up. Ready? You sure? That'll be fine.